Hey guys, in this video, we're going to be looking at some different soil types. I pulled some samples from some different yards that I've worked on, most of them within maybe 15 or 20 miles of each other. So I want you to see that there's quite a wide range of soil types that are out there. And as you start to set up your irrigation system, as you're working out a lawn care program with fertilizers, this is some of the information that you need to know. It also plays into what type of sprinklers should be suggested or should be installed for a particular property. It really has to do with the soil quality and how quickly that a soil will absorb water down into it. It's called the infiltration rate. And what we're concerned with is the root zone. You know, most plants don't take in a whole lot of water from the leaves, from the plant matter that's above ground. But take turf, for instance. It takes in somewhere around 3 or 4% or less of its total water intake from the blades. That means that we have to be very concerned with what's happening at the root level, which is really 6 inches down in the ground. That's the A horizon, and that's where you're going to find the majority of your root zone. And turf, for instance, you really should have at least a 6-inch depth to your roots. So we're going to be looking at these different soil types, and we're going to do some identification on it so we can have some of this good information ready. And as we take a look at this video here, we're going to look at our basic soil types, and we'll go across the entire spectrum from the largest of particles, which is over here on the left side of your screen, and that's basically our sand. And then we're going to work our way across a couple of different soil types, all the way down here to clay, which is the smallest of particles. So let's start off on the largest of the spectrum here, and that's sand. And we've actually got 5 different classifications for sand. We have coarse, very coarse, medium, fine, and very fine. And these sizes can range all from very large all the way down, and the infiltration rate can be as much as 1 inch per hour, or it can be all the way down to maybe 0.3 inch per hour. And that's a pretty small particle here. And you know, what we're looking at is a sterilized sand, and it has some other particles in it. So, you know, it's very rare to find these pure soil types. So we're going to look at some mixtures here. And the first off is kind of a sandy, silty mixture, and it's got some organic particles here and a combination of different size particles. And because of the color, we can see that it's dark, almost starting to get black. So we know it's got some organic matter that's building up in it there. And so, you know, little by little, it's going to get a little darker. But let's take a look at this other one. This is a heavier clay content in it, and it's a little bit darker. And this has got what's called loam in it. And loam isn't really a particle. It's just more of a combination of sand, organic matter, clay, and the organic humus that builds up from plants decomposing. And the infiltration rate of these two middle types can be anywhere between 0.25 to 0.40 inches per hour, you know, and that's 1/4 inch of water per hour to 0.4 inch of water per hour. And, you know, these type of organic, you know, soils that have this makeup in it, they've got a lot of cracks and crevices in there that can hold it. See, but sand, you know, it really can't hold on to the water nor the nutrients very well. So we're going to be looking into that, but these other type can really hang on to it. But let's look at clay here. Clay has the smallest of particle sizes, and it's got just a little bit of mica ground in there. It's what you see shining in the light a little bit. But clay, you know, the particles are shaped like saucers, and as it dries out, these saucers, you know, get very close to each other and held together with electrostatic force. And the infiltration rate of these can be very poor, from 1/10 inch of water per hour, maybe up to 0.3 inch. But when it gets dried out and it, you know, it makes a crust on the soil that we see in July and August, can get really hard, and the infiltration rate can get all the way down to 1/20 inch of water per hour. So you see a lot of water that just rolls off of clay landscapes. So, you know, it does get really, really dry here in South Carolina. So, what we do, we're going to add a little bit of water to this, and we're going to see, you know, how much of the soil is made up of clay. And that's what we really want to look at, because, you know, with the sand here, it was a very high infiltration rate. We can use just about any irrigation product with that, and it'll be okay. but what we really need to be concerned with is how much clay it is, and then we'll have to select products that slow down that precipitation rate so that the ground can have time to absorb. Now look at this sand here. Now all sand's going to stick together a little bit, but it doesn't clump together very easily, and as we I've squirted some water in here. We're going to try to get it to clump together, but it really just falls apart really easily. And this has actually probably got just a little bit of clay in it just because it has clumped. But let's move on here to the next one and wet this down real good and see what we're working with. I can see from the color that it has a little bit of clay in there. It looks like it's clumping up a little bit. It's not bad. We'll put a little bit more water on it here and see how it does. And it really kind of has to be saturated, and you want to squeeze out the extra water and then see how it clumps up and how hard that clump is. That's pretty decent. That's a decent soil right there. That's probably, really easy to get a nice deep root zone with. It doesn't clump up that hard when it's completely saturated, which means it'll still leave a little bit of oxygen in there. So let's take a look at this one here. It's got a whole lot more clay content. Let's get this good and wet down. I'm pretty sure that this is going to clump up really quickly into a nice hard clump. Let's see what happens here. We squeeze this extra water out. And this is going to stick together really well. See how quickly it clumps up there. I mean, it's really got that kind of clay look to it, so we know it has a high clay content. And so let's take a look at the real clay here, and I know exactly what's going to happen with it. It's going to clump up almost immediately with a little bit of water on it. And you can see that once it gets saturated, it has a very hard time absorbing any more water. And that's because of the particle size, the electrostatic force holding it together. But it's very detrimental for your plants to have this kind of pure clay because it squeezes out everything, microbes, oxygen. So, we just want to see how this goes and how this clumps, and that'll help make our decision here as to how we're going to treat this soil. So I hope this visual representation here of these soil types helps you out. And take up a good shovel full of dirt in your own yard and check it out for yourself and see what you think.